جراح أمتي الثكلى تنادي فهبوا يا بني.
And the other Muslim rulers said to Salahuddin, they said, oh Salahuddin, we will give you money, go back. And Salahuddin said, how can I unite with you people? How can I negotiate with you people when you are in one valley and I am in another valley? The valley that he attributed to them was the value of this dunya, the value of preserving their kingdoms, while the value that he attributed to himself was the valley which led to the akhirah, the value of preserving this ummah. And this is why Shaykh Abu al-Hasan Nadwi rahmatullah alayhi, he said, he defined, once defining Salahuddin, he says, kana mu'minan musliman muhammadiyan la ya'rifu ghayra lughati al-quran. He said Salahuddin was a Muslim, he was a Muhammadi, he was a mu'min. The only language that he understood was the language of the Quran. The only language that he understood was the language of Islam and Iman. And Stanley Lane Poole mentioned that when Salahuddin came into Jerusalem, he showed the Christians the meaning of compassion. The Muslim king showed the Christians the meaning of compassion.
But for Muslims and non-Muslims alike, one of the things that he did that was so significant was that he didn't replicate exactly what the Christians had done. Because what they did about 88 years earlier on, and this was written in the memoirs of those individuals that were fighting at the time, and they wrote in the memoirs that when the Crusades came to Jerusalem, they ransacked the area, and with their horses, they came into Jerusalem from one area to another, from the north to the south, destroying anything in its path. And they came back on horseback. They came all the way back to the front and they started again, going right to the end, destroying everything that they can. Until they wrote in their memoirs that the horses were swimming in the blood of the Muslims. And their legs, yes, up until the feet of those that were sitting on the horseback, their feet were drenched in the blood of the Muslims. So this was something that the Muslims didn't forget. It was something that the Muslims had in mind. The Muslims were well aware of it. In fact, the Christians were well aware of this fact, of what their predecessors had done. Because they expected Salahuddin to do exactly the same. But he didn't. That's the thing. He didn't do that. He prevented a bloodshed of Muslims and non-Muslims. And there was 100,000 Christians at the time. So he spared the lives of 100,000 Christians. He also, not only did he spare their lives, but he also gave them a safe journey, a safe departure with their property and with their belongings. So he said, you're free. He said, you're free to go.
When one of the Muslims had, or Antioch, one of the Muslims had taken a child that belonged to a Frankish woman, had stolen the baby of a non-Muslim, of a Frankish Christian from a tent, and had run off with him. One of them took a child, a nursing child, a feeding child. فَوَجَدَتْ عَلَيْهِ أُمُّهُ وَجْدًا شَدِيدًا وَاشْتَكَتْ إِلَى مُلُوكِهِمْ فَقَالُوا. And she became so upset, like any mother would become upset if her child was taken. And so she complained to her king. And she's weeping and crying, and they said, إِنَّ مَلِكَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ رَحِيمَ الْقَلْبِ. The king of the Muslimin has a soft heart, has a merciful heart. فَأَذَنَا أَن تَذْهَبِي إِلَيْهِ وَتَشْتَكِي إِلَيْهِ. We give you permission to go to him and complain your case to him. فَرَقَّ لَهَا رَقَّةً شَدِيدًا حَتَّى دَمْعَتْ أَيْنَاهُ. And he was so moved by the story, by the account of that Frankish woman, that even he began to cry. And that is the one you all know of, Salahuddin al-Ayyubi rahimahullah.
Salahuddin, he ordered his soldiers. He said, go and find all of the missing guardians. And he goes, those individuals, and that's what they did. They went out and they found the missing guardians for these women, for these Christian women, and then gave them and their safe return back to their cities or back to their families, back to their guardians. And those individuals that were unable to find, those women, Christian women, that were unable to find their guardians, Salahuddin ordered his soldiers to give them a liberal compensation. He even compensated.
And the testimony to the greatness of this man is that every single person claimed him. Even his arch enemies claimed him. when the news of his bravery and compassion reached Europe, they couldn't believe that a non-white, non-Christian man could be so brave and so compassionate. So myths began to circulate in Europe that actually Salahuddin was the son of a white Christian princess who was taken into captivity, and then she was married off to a man called Malikin, and from that marriage came forth a man called Salahuddin.
وقد لاقى صدوده وجمودا فمن منكم يقول بملء فيه أعين دين يا